Hi all, and welcome to another video in Statistical Software in Criminal Justice course. This video will show you how to use correlation tests in SPSS. For this video, I have created this dataset, Violent Crime and Poverty. I've taken the data from UCR and American Community Survey. For those of you who want to get data from these sources, I'm just going to show you very quickly. You can go to census.gov and get the data from the American Community Survey or other census data. And also, you can get the data from UCR, from FBI. Okay, so this data set has 16 variables and about 51 observations, one for each state. So there is the population of the state and also some variables that have to do with poverty, such as percent of families that are below poverty level, those families that take SNAP or food stamps, unemployment percentages, and also a couple of variables that depict violent crime, such as violent crime rate, and also, as you can see here, homicide and homicide rate towards the end. So we're going to test one of the most mentioned questions in any of the research, design and methods textbook in criminal justice. Does poverty cause crime? So that is our research question. We have to pose the null hypothesis and the alternative hypothesis in order to use statistical tests to test that hypothesis. The null hypothesis in correlation would be that the true correlation between the two variables, in this case, we're going to get poverty percentage as a measure of poverty and a violent crime rate as measure of crime. So we're going to say that the null hypothesis is that the true correlation between poverty percentage and violent crime rate is zero, or that there is no statistically significant correlation between poverty percentage and violent crime rate. The alternative hypothesis is a two-tailed hypothesis that's going to say that the true correlation between the two variables is not zero, is different from zero, or that there is a statistically significant correlation or relationship between poverty percentage and violent crime rate. So, what do we do here in SPSS? To do a correlation test, we have to go to Analyze, bring down the menu, and then go to Correlate. The Correlate has a submenu, and then we're going to go and select Bivariate. Once we select the Bivariate Correlations dialog box opens up, and we're going to bring the variables of interest into the variables field. So we said that we're going to test the relationship between poverty percentage, so you can just click and drag, or, for example, in the case of the other variable, violent rate, you can click to select it and then click on the right arrow to bring it into the variable box. You can keep Pearson. You also can have Kendall Tau B or Spearman. Spearman correlation sort of utilizes a different formula where it does not give so much weight to extreme values. So that's good for if you don't, for example, assume equal variances between variables. And Kendall Tau is when you rank values and there are so many that have the same rank. In this case, we're not going to bother with these two. We're going to have a two-tailed test of significance because our alternative hypothesis was a two-tailed hypothesis. We're going to flag significant correlations at the alpha 0.05, which is the significance level at which we're going to test our null hypothesis, and then we're going to click OK. The output window opens up and shows us the correlation table. The correlation table gives us a few rows. We're going to just look at the first row, which has three different sub-rows within it. So first, we're going to look at the Pearson correlation. between percent of families living below poverty level and violent crime rate. So as you can see, the correlation coefficient among the variables is going to always be 1 because they have the same values. But what we are interested in is this number right here. This is the Pearson correlation coefficient, 0.481. Now, as you can probably remember from the textbook, also from the materials of the course, this is somewhat a strong relationship. It does not go to the threshold of 0.5, at which point we say that this is a strong relationship, but it's close to that. So we can say that, 1, there exists a relationship, and 2, we can say that there is a positive relationship between poverty percentage and violent crime rate. And 3, we can say that this is a somewhat strong relationship. Now you can see that there are 2 asterisks right here, and that is closely correlated to the second subrow, which is the significance or the p-value, which is smaller than 0.01. What does this mean? This means that the p-value at which we're going to test the null hypothesis is smaller than our threshold level, significance level at 0.05. That is what we decided in the beginning. Since the p-value is below 0.05, then we can say that we reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternative hypothesis. More formally, we can say that the data set shows that there is enough evidence to demonstrate a strong and significant relationship or correlation between poverty percentage and violent crime rate in the United States in years 2020-2021. Now, I just want to show you a quick visualization of this relationship. In order to do that, we're going to go to Graphs, Chart Builder. To make a very quick chart here, we're going to go to Scatter Dot to create a scatter plot, find the simplest one, and then drag it up into this area, and then select the variable that goes into the x-axis and variable that goes into the y-axis. Because the question is poverty causes crime, poverty should be in the x-axis, which is poverty percentage right here. Drag and drop into this box. And then violent rate, drag and drop it into the y-axis box. Once this is done, you don't need to do anything else here. Just click OK. And now you're going to see, let me maximize this a little bit, the scatter plot of violent crime rate by poverty percentage. As you can see, there is sort of a pattern that goes from the lower left to upper right, and that actually shows visually that there is a positive relationship, because there are some values that are sort of extreme here and here and here. This is not as strong as it would have been without these extreme values. Now, if we want to look at a linear line, which we will look at the regression in another video, we can just double click on the graph and then ask for a fit line. So look at that. This is the fit line that fits these data based on the least square order. Let's click close. So this is how this relationship or this correlation between the poverty percentage and violent crime rate looks like. Now, since we are here, let's look at some more correlations between the variables. Let's go to the data set, and I want to look at the poverty percentage, also SNAP percentage, which is the percentage of families that get public assistance or food stamps, and also unemployment percentage, And we're going to see if there is any correlation between those three and the violent rate. And maybe I can throw there the homicide rate. So let's look at those. We go to analyze again, correlate, bivariate. The two variables that we found the correlation before are here. So let's remove violent rate for a moment and get SNAP percentage, get unemployment percentage, and then we're going to get the violent rate and homicide rate as representative of the violent crime variables. We're going to click OK. So the output gives us a bigger table, and we have the correlation coefficients of all variables, of all pairs of variables. What we are interested here is not the correlation coefficient between the pairs of variables that represent poverty or pairs that represent crime. For example, we're not interested in the correlation between violent crime rate and homicide rate, or poverty percentage and SNAP percentage or unemployment percentage among themselves. We are only interested in finding out whether each of these first three variables that represent poverty are correlated with crime variables. So as we can see here, it seems like poverty percentage is highly correlated with homicide rate at 0.604. This is significant at 0.01 level, even more significant than at the significance level of 5% that we set out in the null hypothesis. And it looks like poverty percentage is more highly correlated with crime variables than the other poverty variables. For example, percent of families receiving cash or SNAP is 0.229 and 0.334. Percent of unemployment is with violent crime rate is 0.166, and with homicide rate is 0.335. So all of these are smaller than the correlation coefficient that the poverty percentage has with violent crime or homicide rate. So it looks like poverty is highly correlated, and we can therefore reject the null hypothesis that there is no relationship and accept the alternative hypothesis that there is a significant relationship between poverty percentage and crime. Now, all we can do here is say that there is a significant correlation, but we cannot really say that poverty percentage caused the crime or violent crime rate or homicide rate. However, there is one thing that you can do in the correlation, and that is to square the correlation coefficient. So, for example, if you square the correlation coefficient between poverty percentage and homicide rate, which is 0.6, and you square that, you're going to get 0.36. Now, that is going to show that 36% of the variation in homicide rate is explained by the variation in poverty percentage. This is as much as we can do given the limitation of the correlation coefficient in terms of prediction or finding out cause and effect. So this concludes this video, and thank you for watching.